So an interesting new feature of Pages, Numbers, and Keynote that was just added is the ability to have image galleries. And this is where you can put more than one image in a space and kind of flip through them like a little slideshow. So here I am in Pages version 7. And the way to get image galleries is go to the Media button here. And you can see Image Gallery has been added to the list. You can also find it under Insert and there's Image Gallery. So either way, you bring it in and it creates this little element here. And you can arrange the element just like anything else. So stay with page, move with text, how the text wrap and all that happens. And in order to get images in there, either you can drag and drop files or you can click on this little button here and then select files. So I'm going to drag and drop three images in here. And it's going to add them. And now I can see I've got three dots here below it. I can click on the dots to see the three images. I've got some options here on the right. If I have Format selected and then Gallery, I can see under Appearance whether or not there's a caption. I can get rid of it. And whether or not the same caption for all images or individual captions. So like individual captions, I'll just do this as A. I'll click on the second dot. This is B. And the third dot and then C. And then I can make adjustments. If I double click on an image, I get the same image editing tools I get for a normal image. I can zoom in. I can pan around in the zoomed in area. I can crop as well. So I can just adjust each image as I want. I've got buttons here in the left and right. And this is when I view it in Pages. I can use these buttons to go between them. Also notice here on the right, I've got a list of these images and I can see them here. And I can easily drag and drop them to reorder them. I can hit the plus button to add a new one. I can select and hit the minus button or hit the delete key on my keyboard to get rid of one. Also, for any image I've got selected, I can type an image description. You can use this just for notes, but what it's meant for is for VoiceOver. If somebody's using VoiceOver and they go select this image, this is what will be read out loud to them. So in the accessibility features there. There doesn't seem to be any way to do a border, so you probably have to put a shape underneath it and put a border. And then you've got your little image gallery on the page. So I imagine that this could be used in a variety of different ways. Of course, if you distribute the Pages file, somebody can actually flip through it. Exporting, of course, it's not going to appear if you export as a PDF, at least not in preview. It doesn't seem to appear anywhere except EPUB. If I export as EPUB and then I take that, either a reflowable or fixed layout EPUB, it doesn't seem to matter. I export, I'll export it here to the desktop, and then I bring that file into iBooks. I'll just double click on it to do that. So that'll launch iBooks. It'll import that document in there. Open it up and you can see here I'm viewing it in iBooks and I have the controls at the bottom. So I even get the buttons here if I move my cursor over them and the captions appear. So it does seem to work in EPUB format. That's probably what it really was built for if you want to distribute your documents that way. You also can use image galleries in Numbers and in Keynote as well. It makes a lot of sense to use them in Keynote if you insert one into a slide and then drag some images to it. You have the same exact controls as before, but now you actually can flip through the slides when you play the presentation. So I'm on this slide now, and if I tap the right arrow, you can see it actually goes through each of those images before advancing to the next slide. So a really handy way to throw a bunch of images in. You can then put other things around it. We had some functionality like this in an older version of Keynote, and this kind of brings that back, which is nice. If you, in the middle of your presentation, suddenly want to show 30 different images of slides for photos or something, then you can do it just one slide and don't have to create a whole set of them just to hold that slideshow.